Christopher Hyder controls for the Jaguars. Remember, Cameron Monroe fouled out at about the 8-minute mark. Snow the catch. Rogers the three ball.
That was good action. The shot just didn't go, but they got it inside. The defense collapsed, and they got it to the three-point shoot. That was good offense.
Devarell Biggs has not had a field goal today. What a time! First post! Texas Southern up by a point.
What a move. Slicing right through the defense and at the last moment hanging in the air to finish it with his offhand is left.
Traylon Banks, the coach's kid, with an answer on the other end. Back and forth we go. TSU led by a point of a half. Southern has led the entire second half until that previous basket. Quick trigger. Malcolm Riley, it's been his day, but not that time.
This is exactly what you want for a championship game. A game back and forth. Both teams hungry, vying for this championship.
Trey Lynch, two big steps. And he can't hit, and the smallest man on the floor with the rebound. The SWAC Player of the Year. That's Devarell Biggs, I beg your pardon. Biggs, the big hit.
That was big. That was a clutch three right there.
How about Mike Davis putting him back in after a slow game? Traylon Banks answers with the three. And Banks showing some emotion as the Jaguars take a two-point lead.
Well, hey, in this last minute and a half, we've just had fireworks back and forth. Both teams, you see right here the penetration. Biggs getting to the basket and finishing strong, and the counter coming right back at the other end. The defense doesn't come up and stop the basketball, and he sees a big basket, but the counter here, you see the coach's son, Banks, saw hands down, man down, and drilled that three.
Beyond the NBA arc, these kids get in this NBA arena, they start shooting from long range, 2 or 3 feet. Behind that three-point line.
Well, that was the kind of fireworks I was expecting for 40 minutes, but I'm glad we saw a little bit of it the last minute and a half, but both teams in the end, back and forth, and, you know, right now it's a two-point game, and Southern just burned another timeout, so, you know, they're going to go in here with just two timeouts to go.
Texas Southern already has the automatic bid from the SWAC to the NCAA tournament, their second in as many years. A couple of years ago, Southern won this tournament. They went to the Big Dance and played Gonzaga. They weren't eligible this year or this season. So this, as you have termed all day, Stan, is their Super Bowl, their big opportunity to finish off the season on a high note and claim the tournament championship.
Well, this is a gritty team, a tough team. When you think about the adversity these kids have faced, the coaching staff has faced, Coach Banks, and to put themselves in a position like this to play for the championship of the SWAC, knowing that you're not going to the NCAA tournament, that speaks about the character of the program. And going forward, once they get through the NCAA ban, you know, they've got a terrific head coach that's going to continue to allow this program to compete for championships for Southern University.
Texas Southern with the ball down by two. Madarius Gibbs leaning in, and he drew the foul.
I'm not sure if I like that call right there. Because I thought it was very good defense. The defense slid, he cut him off, and you know, it's contact, but there's going to be some contact. You know, it's just one of those play on. You know, both teams competing, the players decided on the court.
The 11 today for Gibbs. No player in the country averages more minutes per game than Madarius Gibbs. He's that important to be on the court, and he gets to the line a lot. Right now trying to tie up this game. It'll be the first tie since 22-all, and he can't do it.
Key miss right here, but you've got time. You've got time to get a stop right here. No need to foul.
Christopher Hyder looking to the bench for a play. Rogers with the step. Devereaux bigs the rebound. The Tigers are going to push. Malcolm Riley to the rim. Oh, my. And a pile of bodies, and Riley down.
Well, so far, nice job. Everybody's staying calm. The coach is keeping everybody on the sideline. And now you see the coaches getting their players, making sure nothing extra happens, but a hard, hard foul, and definitely a flagrant. Whether it's a flagrant one or two, that will be the issue.
Our officiating crew, John Heatley, Chuck Jones, and Byron Jarrett have some work to do.
And, well, you know, remember this, if it's a flagrant two, the player is ejected from the game, but they're not playing more games, but it could be tagged on into the future. But if it's flagrant one, then it's two shots. Both are going to be two shots and the ball, so a huge thing for Texas Southern. They're going to get the basketball back.
Stan, I think that's ejection worthy.
I totally agree. Yeah, he made no attempt, and it was hard. It was at the head, landed on top of him. Yeah, I agree with you. Flagrant two should be ejected for the game.
That's Traylon Banks, the man who got the foul. Then Trey Lynch, the other Trey, fell on Riley. This is a Trey sandwich. Trey Banks with the foul. Trey Lynch with the hammer at the end. And Malcolm Riley got up after several seconds down as the officials go to the monitor for a review.
Extremely excessive.
Keep in mind, when these two teams got together in Baton Rouge, we had three monitor reviews inside 7/10 of a second. This one for a different reason. Right now, getting an explanation. And Riley being attended to on the bench.
The officials just came over and confirmed a flagrant two ejection. So he will be dismissed from this basketball game, which is the right call.
Stan, I understand not wanting to give up a free layup as we look at the flagrant one, flagrant two, and certainly excessive, severe, and not playing the ball. So it's going to be two shots and a ball, but the question is, who's going to shoot the free throws? Because Malcolm Riley, we just saw him on the bench with his head wrapped up. And there's Riley.
Well, Mike Davis gets to choose who will shoot those free throws. So that's what's been decided. Riley can't come back into this game, so there was no other alternative. He got to choose from his bench, and that's the guy he wanted.
Riley has 18 of the 57 points for Texas Southern on the bench for the time being with his head wrapped as Devereaux Biggs ties up the game for the first time since it was 22 apiece back in the first half. So the coach's son, Traylon Banks, ejected, and Biggs puts Texas Southern up by a point, and they'll get the basketball.
They get the basketball back in.
Stan, the message to young players is you just have to play the basketball. I don't care how much you want to stop the layup.
Everything that we just saw on a flagrant two, you know, the top part is what happened. It's excessive. No play on the basketball, and it was hard. So the right call by the officials, and now Texas Southern gets the basketball back, and they're up by one, so they don't have to take a shot. Obviously, Southern's going to have to foul in this situation or play for a steal.
Biggs got up in the air, and that ball knocked to the bounds. It'll stay Texas Southern basketball.
And I like what Texas Southern do. Biggs just hit two free throws. They're trying to make sure they get him the basketball back to shoot these two free throws again if they get fouled.
Gibbs fouled immediately by Trey Lynch.
Well, you have to imagine right now with tempers a little bit warm because of the hard foul. The referees are going to call this very close down the stretch to make sure nothing extra happens.
Even before last Saturday when these two teams played here at TSU, the women's game between these two schools ended in a double forfeit because of an altercation on the floor. Heated moment. So here it is playing for a conference tournament championship. Texas Southern had those free throw makes from Devarell Biggs, but Madarius Gibbs just missed.
Obviously, these teams are very competitive, but I don't think there's any malicious, hard foul. I don't think Banks intentionally went to, hey, I want to hurt this guy, but the situation presented where he was trying to foul, and he did it too hard. It was extremely excessive.
And the last big hit for Southern came from Banks on a three-pointer. He has been ejected, so somebody else is going to have to step up. Banks has been ejected. Cameron Monroe fouled out with the 8-minute mark. And we know Texas Southern already has the automatic bid, courtesy of the SWAC tournament. Southern not eligible because of APR issues. And Southern has really led throughout this entire second half until that crazy play in which Malcolm Riley was driving to the basket and Traylon Banks went in for the hard foul. So Riley on the bench while Devarell Biggs made a couple of huge free throws to give his team a one-point lead. And it's worth one more look, full speed, full time.
Yeah, again. He's got the basket. There was no play on the basketball. And it was above the shoulders at the head area. So that was the right call. Officials got it right. The coaches did a great job of not allowing anything to escalate further by guys coming onto the floor. And the players were removed from each other right away from where the foul occurred.
All right, Stan, what do you do here if you're the Southern Jaguars?
Well, I think you play for two. There's plenty of time, but you want to score quickly, so there's time just in case you miss the shot or you get a chance for an offensive rebound. I believe right now they're getting a little bit too deep in this clock.
For the lead, Chris Thomas, the basketball foul with 2.9 to play. The three-point shooter, Trey Lynch, tried to put the Jaguars back up a point, and the rebound came to TSU, and another Southern Jaguar has fouled out.
Southern had a lot more time and really, you know, went through their offense side to side and burned a lot of time and ended up with a three-point shot that was contested. So not an easy shot. Trey Lynch, a guy who gets streaky, can get hot, but probably could have got an easy two by driving the ball and drawing a foul and extending the game out. But Texas Southern didn't seem to be able to get the stop they needed throughout the course of the game, but in this situation, they did.
Jared Sam fouled out. So a couple of free throw makes from Chris Thomas would make this a two-possession game. 54% free throw shooter on the season. Texas Southern trying to win its 22nd game of the year. Upsets at Michigan State and Kansas State. The SWAC regular season champions already have their bid punched to the big dance, trying to claim the SWAC tournament championship. And that'll do it. Texas Southern has won, defeating the Southern Jaguars 62-58.
Well, a great comeback win by Mike Davis and the Texas Southern Tigers. And they just grinded this one out. It wasn't pretty. They were able to just kind of stay in the basketball game. And that critical play down the stretch, the hard foul, cemented the game.
The celebration of the Texas Southern Tigers, their second consecutive tournament victory, and they sweep it, regular season and tournament, for Mike Davis's team.
Well, rightfully so, and if you're Texas Southern, you didn't want to back your way into the NCAA tournament by saying, hey, by default, we get in because the other team was ineligible for postseason play. You go out and you win it the right way. You win the regular season, you win the tournament championship, you are the true SWAC champion. Great job by Mike Davis, his staff, his players, his fans, his administration. They're doing a heck of a job going back to back into the NCAA tournament.
Think this didn't mean something to the kids? Look at the celebration. Our